Let's do an optimization problem here. A rectangle is bounded by the x and y axis and the graph of y equals to 4 minus 1 half x. What length and width should the rectangle have so that its area is maximized? Okay, so here's the graph here. And here's the curve, y equals to 4 minus 1 half x. And it's in green here. And you can form a rectangle between the curve and the axis here. Okay, so this corner of the rectangle here will always lie on this curve here, and it can lie on any point on this curve here. So for example, if it lies here, let's say, lies on this point of the curve, then the length of the rectangle will be here, and the width will be here. And let's say, for example, if it lies on this point here, then the length of the rectangle will be like this, will be longer, but the width will be here, right, shorter. But on which point that this corner should lie on so that the area of this rectangle is maximized? So in order to find that out, basically we're looking for the length and the width of the rectangle. Okay, so take a look at this. What is the length of this rectangle here? It's represented by x. And what's the width of this rectangle here? It's represented by the y. So we can write this here. X is the length of the rectangle, right? And Y is the width of the rectangle. Now, what's the area of the rectangle? We're looking for area, right? So we have to talk about the area formula. So what's the formula for the area of a rectangle? It's length times width, right? Yes. So the area of the rectangle is length times width, and the length is x, width is y, so it's x times y. That's it, right? Okay, so this is an optimization problem. So we have to take the derivative and find the maximum value. However, this is one variable x, one variable y. So we have two variables here, and you're trying to take the derivative here. It's not that easy. So what we should do is trying to find one variable and try to write that variable in terms of another variable so that we can substitute into here so that we have only one variable to work with. Okay, we do know that from the question, y is equal to 4 minus 1 half x. So we have y in terms of x right here, right? Yes, so here, y equals to 4 minus 1 half x. So we can just take this, and then substitute into y here. So the area is x times y, and y is 4 minus 1 half x. So 4 minus 1 half x. Now, just distribute the x. We have this is equal to 4x minus, now this will be 1 half x squared. Okay, now we have area in terms of only the x variable, which is the length. Okay, now we're going to take the derivative of the area with respect to x so that we can find out what kind of length, what's the value of length will give the maximum area. So we have take dA over dx, and right, take the derivative here. This is 4 minus, okay, bring the power to the front and then subtract 1 from the power, you get x here. Okay, to get the value for the x, right, that will maximize the area of the rectangle, right? Basically, we have to find the maximum point, right? So we have to set that equal to zero, the slope, right, of the curve equal to zero, because you know that over here, this is a parabola, and it's a minus sign in the front, so it's a downward opening parabola. So you want to find the maximum value here, right? The slope of the curve here will be zero, so you have to set dA over dx equal to zero, right? The slope equal to zero. 4 minus x. Oh, simple now, right? If that's the case, you add x to both sides and x is equal to 4. So we find out that x is equal to 4. That will give the maximum area of the rectangle. Then what is y? Well, we have y in terms of x here. We just need to plug the x that we calculated in here, which is the 4. We calculate what the y is. Okay, so now we have this. y equals to 4 minus 1 half x, and we know that x is equal to 4, so we put 1 half and then put x here, right? We put 4 into x here. So now, 4 minus what's 4 times 1 half is 2, right? Y is equal to 4 minus 2 is just 2. Okay, so we have the answer, right? Because the question is asking, what length and width should the rectangle have so that its area is maximized? The length, remember, the length is x, the width is y. So the length is 4, the width is 2. That will give the maximum area of the rectangle. So let's try to calculate the maximum area. And we know that, right? X should be 4 and y should be 2 to give the maximum area of the rectangle. 2 times 4 is 8, right? Unit square. So whatever the unit is, but it's 8 unit square. So the area, the maximum area of the rectangle is 8 unit square. And the length should be 4. And the width should be 2 to give the maximum area of the rectangle. Hope you enjoyed this video. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Thank you.